Welcome back, everyone. We are joined now by George Hills and his granddaughter, Callie, who has come all the way up from Dallas just to be here with us this morning. And we are here to talk about a children's book that you have recently written.
That's right. That's right.
And Callie here is kind of the inspiration and how you got started writing.
She was my original inspiration.
Books,
yes.
In the first place. So yeah. Tell us, what is Flutterly and Baby Blue about?
Yeah. Well, it's about two sister butterflies and their adventure in the forest with all their animal friends. And then with the high winds, Baby Blue goes missing. And then she can't find her. Jesse the squirrel and Hoot the owl, they all go looking for her. Short story long, they find a boy with a butterfly net. And he's got Baby Blue in a jar. So the adventure now continues. How are they going to save Baby Blue? And I'm not going to tell you how it happens. You
have to Don't ruin it.
You have to buy the book to find out how she is saved.
Callie, what's it like to see your grandfather kind of living out his dreams and being able to see it all come to fruition like this?
It's awesome. I mean, I'm just so proud of him. It's something that he's always done for all of us grandkids. We've got a lot of grandkids. So it's something we've always done, and he's always told lots of stories, and it's just something he loves to do. So it's great. He's finally put it on paper.
Did you think that it would ever get this far?
I didn't, honestly, but my mom's always known. My mom's the one who told him, record the stories you're telling the kids. Write them down. You should put these in books. You could make money off of it.
So what has your process been to do that? Because isn't that how you did it?
It's taken about a year.
Uh-huh.
And I submitted this to my publisher a year ago. And it's writing the story is easy. Publishing, it's a different story. It takes a lot of work. And working with my illustrator, who did a phenomenal job with the colors and the artwork, it just brings those characters to life. My goal was to not have cartoonish animals. Mm-hmm. I wanted to humanize them a little bit because they are communicating.
Why do you think it's important for kids to be reading and interacting and hearing stories like what you've shared with your grandkids for so many years?
Well, the idea is that to paint a picture in their mind. And then they can learn to read by just following the stories and listening to you reading to the child. And that, you know, being able to recall what that story was about and retain that information.
And Callie, probably making memories that you'll have forever.
Oh, for sure. I mean, we sat around the Christmas tree, and I still remember him naming the seals that he decorated the tree with. And we would all kind of create the personalities with him and stuff. So it was awesome. It was really fun. So
my website's PapaGeorgeBooks.com.
PapaGeorgeBooks.com.
You could go there, you could check out the pictures, and then you can even order it. One click and the book is theirs. And they'll have it. I'll be with Barnes & Noble this summer and Amazon Books.
Congratulations.
Sky's the limit.
Well, thanks for
being here. Well, thank you for having me here.
Callie, thanks for coming out of all the way from Dallas, Texas. We really appreciate it.
Of course, of course.
But Utterly Flutterly and Baby Blue is available, guys.
Okay.
Easy to get to.
Awesome. Thanks so much for being here. We'll take a short break, everyone. We have your headlines coming your way right after this.